Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/APOD. And today's picture for March the 5th of 2020, well, it is titled The Light, the Dark, and the Dusty. So what do we see here? Well, this is a region of the constellation of Cepheus, which is one of the regions on our galactic plane. So we're looking towards the direction of our galaxy here and the concentrations of material and star-forming regions that we see that populate the portions of our galaxy. Now, our galaxy is a spiral galaxy which has gas and dust in it which undergo star formation as they collapse. And a region like this is a very rich star-forming region, and within it we see a number of different parts of this, including the reddish glow. The red glow is due to hydrogen gas. When hydrogen gas is excited, its electrons will be removed from it, and as they recombine with the hydrogen nuclei, they will then give off specific wavelengths of light, and very prominent in the visible is red. So the red glow we see here is due to hydrogen gas that has been excited, and the reason this is associated with star formation is that it is excited by hot stars, and hot stars don't live very long, so they must have formed relatively recently in order to have done this. We can also see some other nebulae here. We can see bluish-colored nebulae. These are reflection nebulae. And a reflection nebula is the reflection of dust. So it's dust around a star that has formed. So again, a relatively young star, very blue. And the dust is very good at scattering the blue light out, but not the red color. So we get this bluish glow around some of these stars from the dust that is left over from their formation. We can also see dark nebulae, dark, dusty areas where we cannot see through into what is going on there, at least not with visible light. The visible light does not penetrate through the dust, so we can't see what's going on there. However, if we were to look in the infrared, we would be able to see through this area and see that this is a stellar nursery where new stars are still continuing to form today. And could we come back in a few hundred thousand years, we would see new stars that have emerged out of this, what is now a dark area. The last thing that we can see associated with star formation is an example of a Herbig-Haro object. And that is down below here, and that is jets of material from a young star that has just formed, and as those that material strikes into the interstellar medium, it causes it to glow. So in this case, we're not actually seeing the star itself, but we're seeing the effects of the star and the material that has been expelled out from jets of material along the axes of the star as they strike other material in the interstellar medium. So today we get to see a number of different signs of star formation in the northern region of the sky around the constellation of Cepheus. So that was our picture of the day for March the 5th of 2020. It was titled The Light, the Dark, and the Dusty. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.